Yes.
Hello, chaps. Wolfgore here, and welcome back to Fallout 4, one quest at a time. So, I have a little story to tell. It's not a happy story overall, but it does have something of a happy ending.
Across the Commonwealth.
So, I lost four darn episodes. Four. And that really stings. That's, you know, like a 6 hours day worth of work just gone forever. And what we've been doing is starting the Brotherhood of Steel quest line. As you can see, we are on the Pridewin, which is that floating metal blimp that is their headquarters.
Let's talk to
and I'll pull up the quest that we did real quick so you can see what you missed. We did Cleansing the Commonwealth, the first Quartermastery mission, Semper Invicta, Call to Arms, Fire Support, and yeah, so I think the last thing you saw was like the Gilded Grasshopper and Fire Support, something like that. So we started the Brotherhood of Steel. You didn't miss anything too super pivotal. It was just us, you know, meeting Paladin Dance and his other subordinates, I guess. I can't recall their names off the top of my head, but they're assholes. It's Knight Reese and Scribe Halen. Right here, you can see their names. So we did some little quests for them. We got accepted into the Brotherhood, and we've already been promoted to the rank of Knight. But on the topic of losing the episodes, what has been happening, and this is only happening with Fallout 4 for some reason, I've been using my Elgato capture card, and what happens is that sometimes the audio will just become completely corrupted. You can't even make out what I'm saying, and it's all just garbled and distorted, and I thought before this that it was maybe because the capture card was overheating, because when I'd be using it for, let's say, longer than 4 hours, that always seemed to be the point when it started to get garbled. So up to, since I lost episode 5 and episode 10, I've been just trying to keep my recording times under 3 hours. And I went and did a big old recording day. I edited up the first episode, and then the other four were all completely garbled and destroyed, and I was so pissed. So I sat down, I did research, I just troubleshot the issue all day, and I came up with what I think is a pretty elegant solution. So I ended up downloading a program called Audacity, and it's just an audio capture program completely separate from my Elgato capture card. And then I also found a way to separate the audio file from being exported with the video file through my Elgato. So now, if the audio does get corrupted, I am still using my Elgato, but if the audio gets corrupted, I should be able to just throw out the commentary that the Elgato captured and plug in the backup audio from Audacity. So we shouldn't be having this problem again. And it's a little bit of extra work per episode, but all in all, I think it's a pretty good, elegant solution to the problem that I've been having. And hopefully we won't lose any more episodes for you guys. And for the record, I did check my old save to see if I could go back and redo all the Brotherhood questline, but I would have to go back to before we did an Unlikely Valentine, which is where we went and saved Nick, which was way long in the past, so that is not really an option. Other than that, we are up to level 18 now. Since you missed probably a few levels and a few perks, we're just going to go over that real quick. So we have 3 points in Big Leagues, 3 points in Sneak, 2 in Lone Wanderer, 2 in Attack Dog, 1 point into Locksmith, 2 into Idiot Savant, 2 into Ninja, 2 into Critical Banker, and 1 into Blitz. So that's where we currently are. And I am genuinely, genuinely sorry for the break in immersion. But, you know, you just gotta roll with the punches in this industry. There's not much else I can do about it more than I already have. As far as guns that we are currently using, I don't think anything's changed much. We are still using Terror and Shiv as our main weapons. We have our unlimited ammo capacity sniper rifle, that is. It doesn't have unlimited ammo, it just doesn't have to reload, which is actually very, very nice. And it's still pretty weak, but it helps. And then we have our legendary 10mm, the final shot deals double damage. And I do need to change out one of the mods in that one. I swapped it out for one that makes it shoot super fast, because I thought that might be good with the perk, but after trying it, I don't like it. So we are going to go back to a different mod on that. Yeah, so I think that covers about everything. We are here in the Pridewin. And we have been asked to go around and meet all of the essential personnel. So let's just start
doing
that.
Glad you finally stopped by, soldier. Are you ready for your medical exam?
Oh my. No? Okay. Hello?
Sure. Go right ahead. All right. I'm going to ask you a series of medical-related questions, and I'd like you to answer me to the best of your ability. First question.
Fair
enough. As a child, were you ever exposed to radiation for an extended period of time?
Not that I know of.
There wasn't that much radiation around before the bombs fell.
Before the bombs? What? Let me check my notes. You were a vault dweller? You're probably healthier than anyone else aboard. Anyway, sorry I missed that in your records. Just going down the list of questions. I'm sure you understand. Okay, second question. Have you ever had or come in contact with a person confirmed to be carrying a communicable disease?
Well, there was that one time in Bora Bora, but you don't need to know about that.
Honestly, I don't remember.
Well, you don't appear to be suffering from any long-term ill effects, so I'll assume you haven't. Third question, and please answer honestly. Have you ever had sexual relations with any species considered non-human?
No.
No.
What's wrong never with had, you, no. man? Do Last I look like question. A raider?
Would you have any problems pulling the trigger on an enemy of the Brotherhood, whether they're human, formerly human, or machine?
I mean, as long as I can stab them, as long as that's kosher, then I'm happy.
I suppose so.
Good enough. Excellent. I think I've got all the information I need. I see no reason to prevent you from beginning your duties immediately. If you ever need medical assistance, you let me know.
Okay. Nice meeting you. This actually isn't stealing. So we can just kind of grab all this good loot. Oh, I can't take his microscope. What the heck? Look at all this stuff. This is great.
Good to see you again, Knight. Anything I can do to help?
Oh, wow. There is tons of loot in here. Thanks, Doc. Are you just keeping some human bones there under the table? That seems pretty sanitary, pretty reasonable. Not weird at all. Oh, that one's not interactable? Neither is that. Interesting. Hello.
Ah, good. You're finally here. Just set the books down anywhere. I'll get to them as soon as I can.
Books?
I think you're confusing me with someone else.
Perhaps I need to rummage through the supply bins for a new pair of glasses. Since it's obvious that you aren't who I was expecting, would you mind telling me why you're here?
Of course.
Maxon wanted me to meet the crew, so you were next on my list.
Ah, yes. You must be the new recruit described in Paladin Dance's report.
That's
Under
me.
Under normal circumstances, I'd provide you with a proper orientation of my department. However, I'm woefully behind setting up research patrols and getting bombarded with requests for technical documentation. Unfortunately, I'm lacking the personnel needed to get the job done.
I can help.
Maybe I can lend you a hand.
That would be splendid. As you patrol the Commonwealth, keep your eyes open for blueprints, memos, manuals, books, charts. Anything containing useful technical data. I'm authorized to pay you for each bundle of documents that you recover. And if you wish to be assigned to a research patrol, I have plenty of them waiting to be filled. In any event, it was a pleasure to meet you, Knight.
You as well, good sir. You as well. Do you... Oh, okay, it's alive. I was like, why is there a dead cat on your floor? It's pretty suspicious. Ooh, got some food for Captain Kirk. Excellent. Why isn't canned dog food an option to give to your dog to, like, increase your reputation with it? I think that'd be awesome. Might as well
Please,
grab these holotapes. Probably not going to listen to them, because there's so many, but...
I do hope you'll consider assisting me when you're done.
Yeah, of course, brother. I'm sure you've got some quests for me to do.
I think you should stay on point. Your instincts seem to be right on target.
Hungry? Rations are first come, first served.
I'm just gonna be taking all your stuff. Oh, get some drugs behind the counter. Isn't that nice? People of Sanctuary, thank you. And Diamond City.
Yeah.
I'm basically running the whole show at this point.
With the Brotherhood behind us, we'll never fall.
Pretty indiscriminately looting right now, just because there's so much.
There. Try it now.
Nothing. I was supposed to report 10 minutes ago. Can't fix it.
I can fix it. You're the one who decided to kick your way through a mire lurk.
Does that mean I can take one of these?
There it is.
Oh.
Thanks,
and the collection grows. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, it's so metal. Yeah. Thumbnail. You're welcome, future me. Oh, yeah, look at all this stuff. This is great. Oops. Well, that's fine. It can sit right there for now. Not really need to be in that just yet. My gosh, this is just Loot City. Absolute Loot City.
Night. Put two in the head and they'll stay dead. Advice to live by.
I like your advice, buddy. I like that. Alright. So, I feel like we've got just about everything in here.
Walking away like that is just plain rude.
And we do have quite a lot of resources at this point. We are not really hurting for anything in particular. So if I miss a few things, it's not really a big deal at this point. There's probably more loot on the other levels, but we don't have to worry about that right now. I'll grab that off camera.
Proud to be serving under Elder Max.
Dr. Tegan.
I had enough.
Step forward, Knight.
Foolish.
Even though they've locked me in this blasted cage, I promise that I won't bite.
Why are you in there?
I'm glad you asked. Now, this is the stowage depot, and I, as you probably already guessed, am the ship's quartermaster, Proctor Tegan. The powers that be have me locked in here, so I can keep an eye on the Brotherhood's valuables. If you need to stock up on supplies before you head out on a mission, this is the place to buy them.
Great.
That's good to know.
I'm glad you're the agreeable type. When I tell most of the new recruits that they have to buy their own equipment, they give me the stink eye. The good news is by having a constant flow of caps, I'm able to buy whatever you bring me. Yeah, I'm mostly interested in weapons, but I'll take anything useful. Of course, if you're just looking to make a few caps on the side, I might have some extra work for you to do.
Great.
What sort of extra work are we talking about?
Oh, no. It's nothing like you're thinking. It just involves a little bit of heavy lifting and interacting with the local farms. And since I'm stuck up here manning this one-man zoo, I need someone to do the legwork for me. After you're done with the meet and greet, we can discuss the details. In the meantime, if you ever need anything else, gun, mod, even ammo, you just let me know.
You got it, Tegan. Thank you for the tip, bro. Okay, so I can't take any of his stuff without it being stealing.
So you're the new knight I heard about. Glad to have you on the team.
Hi, nice to meet you. I like your haircut. Alright, so we've got one more NPC to go talk to, and she is over here. Guessing a mechanic? Are you... Hang on. Oh my, you are a double amputee.
Proctor Ingram?
Man, you are a badass.
So, the new recruit I heard about. Not what I was expecting.
What were you expecting?
The last batch of recruits we took on were Wastelanders.
dirty, beaten up, looking for a handout. They were desperate and looking for an easy out. You look like you're here for a reason. Anyway, since you came down here to meet me, we may as well get it over with. My name's Ingram, and this lovely little grease pit is where you'll usually find me. If your power armor's too tight in the crotch, the Pridwin's about to crash into the ground, or a robot's gone haywire, you come see me.
Got it.
Sounds like you have a pretty full plate.
Plate? Hell, I have a whole table's worth of duties around here. There isn't a day that goes by on this tub without five or six things breaking down. And since I'm stuck in this rig, I'm not quite as spry as I used to be. The work tends to pile up.
Oh, well, you're doing great.
Actually, you seem to be getting around really well.
I suppose it's better than the alternative. Anyway, I'm sure you're here to get your hands on some power armor. There's a pretty decent T-60 suit sitting in Bay 3 that's all yours. The left leg actuator's a bit sticky, but it'll keep the creeps off of you. Oh, and if you need any work done on it, feel free to use the workshops around here.
Now, great.
You'll excuse me. I need to get back to work.
We are going to need a good set of power armor for venturing into the glowing waste eventually. So why don't we go turn this in? I guess we don't have to turn it in.
Waiting to discover that. Greetings, Knight.
Well, fantastic. That's easy.
Make it quick. We have a lot of ground to cover.
So we need to go meet with Elder Maxon. Does Paladin Dance have anything for us?
Ready to continue our mission, soldier?
Yeah.
Ready.
Roger that. Don't worry, boy. I'll make sure this soldier comes home alive.
Oh.
I prefer a laser.
No!
Ah! It's a cleaner shot.
Darn it!
Leaves that memorable ozone smell behind.
I don't want...
Ad Victorium, brother.
You as my companion, Dance. No offense. Now, okay, I gotta go get Captain Kirk back. And it looks like we need to drop off some loot anyways. This should give us some extra carry weight, so I'll grab the rest of the loot on the ship, drop it off in Sanctuary, and you will be greeted by Captain Kirk's cute little face in just a moment.
Come here, boy! Come here, boy!
Dog meat.
Oh, how are you, Captain Kirk? Let's go. Let's go.
It's time to go.
I doubt this canine can match my tactical prowess in battle, but it's your decision.
That might be true, Paladin, but look at him, he's so cute. Alrighty, chaps, so let's see. We did tour of duty for the episode, but it's gonna be a little short. We're only at 26 minutes, and I'm gonna be editing out quite a bit of what I've recorded so far. So let's just go explore the wastelands for a bit. We haven't done that in a while. Just go have a fun, beautiful sunset with Captain Kirk, murdering and looting in the wastelands. What separates us from a raider again? Jump! Jump! Yep. Alright, so we've got Vault 111 over there. I want to say this little building on our mini-map has a comic book in it, if I do recall. Oh my. Oh, Mac, you're almost dead. Who even are you, buddy? Let's just take off this scum real quick. Oh, you're not going anywhere, buddy. Sorry. That was awesome. He went, oh, you bitch! How dare you do that to Captain Kirk? That's what you get. Teach you. I hear a vertebrate. Anybody else hear that? I think the Brotherhood might be around here. Huh. Right on, we got some food. Nothing too crazy, but we definitely got some loot. And did I loot this raider that we just sent flying up a hill with one stab of our tiny knife? Yes, I did. So who are you? Oh, you... Oh, a bar. Hello, Mac.
Hi.
Ah, a new customer. Welcome to Mac's Bar. We are currently open for business. Please excuse the mess.
Do you want to go to Sanctuary?
Nice location.
Thank you kindly. Picked the place myself. Plenty of room for expansion in an up-and-coming neighborhood at an unbeatable price. Anyway, what'll it be?
Sure. Let's take a look.
It'd be really, really cool if we could send him to Sanctuary. I would love to have a bar there. That would be perfect. And we can get rid of some of this excess food that we don't need. Don't need that. I'd love to give that canned dog food to Captain Kirk, but I don't know of a way to. So we might as well sell it. I picked up these experimental plants on the Pride Win. So 10 HP, 5 to Rads, that's really bad. We can just sell that. Instamash, don't need that. Get rid of those pork and beans. Don't need that vodka. Do we have anything else he might want? Oh, he only buys aid items as it is. Alright, great. Made a few caps, nothing wrong with that. It was nice to meet you, Mac. This is Captain Kirk, by the way. So, got a little distracted there. What were we doing? I know there's a few little huts and things worth seeing back here. Behind Sanctuary. So we're just going to keep exploring this area. Makes sense tactically. To scout the area around your settlement. So I think that's what we're going to be doing for the rest of the episode. I definitely see something off in the distance there. Is that anything? No, that's just a crane by Vault 111. How far out does this go? What an intimidating landscape. Thank goodness we have Sanctuary to rest our head at. Ah, here we go, we got a little hut of some kind. Bloodleaf. Not super useful, but no harm in taking it. And we have a locked hut. Oh, let's try to the right. Just a hair more. There it is.
That's it.
Got some oil, some wonder glue, more wonder glue. Oh, this is a nice little starting area. Wonder glue gives 3 adhesive, I believe. So that's 6 adhesive that you can get right behind Vault 111. That's really good to know for starting a new character. Beautiful. Now, well, while we're just running through the woods here, I referenced it quite a few times in the 4 episodes that I lost, but I have, just this last week, started streaming. I wanted to get into streaming, you know, pretty much as soon as I started this channel, and it's taken about 9 months to actually reach that point, because there were some, you know, some roadblocks, a lot of things to learn, but I have started streaming, and it's... Oh my god, it is so fun. Like, I can't even believe how much fun I'm having streaming. I didn't think video games could really get funner. You know what I mean? Like, they're very, very fun. They're how I like to spend my free time. But I didn't think I would ever really find a new level of enjoyment in video games. But I have actually found that with streaming. I'm having such a blast. I'm playing Bloodborne right now. Just playing through start to finish. Character is called Beast Mode. And if you're into Bloodborne or you're into my content, come check out the stream. It's a lot of fun. And I have all my social medias linked down in the down in the section below, whatever that's called, the description below, that's the word I'm looking for, description. Yeah, down in the description below, you can find the links to all my social media, and I will be posting prior to streaming on my Facebook page, the Wolfcore Facebook page, and Twitter. I'm not super active on Twitter yet, but I'm trying to get a little bit more into it, because it is a great way to share stuff like that. So if you would like to check out the stream, I would love to hang out with you, and I'd love it if you just stopped by, even if for a minute, to say hi and see what it's all about. So come on and do that. Anyways, back to the episode. Enough shameless plugging of my stream. Why do they make bloatflies so hard to loot? Oh, there's one. And we have become quite powerful from where we started. Hey, you. That's rude. That's rude. I was just looting one of your brother's corpses for food to eat. And you get upset at me? What's that about? Got the Runaway's holotape. Presumably that's the Runaway. I'm a little curious. Let's check this out. Here we go.
October 22nd, 2077. I finally told them tonight, and it was bad. Real bad. Dad was shouting, telling me I should be ashamed, that I had to get out of the house. Mom just cried, and somehow that hurt worse than anything else. She didn't say a word, not even when I packed my things. I can't go to John. He doesn't even know yet. Maybe he'll never know.
If it weren't
for the cabin, I wouldn't have a place to sleep. Just need some time to think. Last time I was here, I was just a little girl playing clubhouse in this old cabin. Now I'm really scared. Will anything ever be right again?
Wow. That is absolutely heartbreaking. Sounds like this poor girl got pregnant and was shunned by her parents and came to stay here because it was all she knew. It doesn't sound like her gentleman caller, John, was informed of what was going on, and I don't really agree with that decision. Probably should have let John know. He might have been able to help. He might not have died in such a sad place. But nothing we can do about that now. And here we have a comic book.
Hell yeah.
Wasteland Survival Guide. You've collected an issue of the Wasteland Survival Guide. Permanently take 5% less damage from melee attacks. Awesome. Absolutely awesome. We definitely get up and personal a lot and take a lot of melee attacks ourselves, so that is just fantastic. So we got that little cabin there. Got a settlement up ahead that we can unlock for the Minutemen. But I think let's go and clear this little factory, and if I recall, we're going to have some ghouls to fight and some loot to be gained. And we'll probably call it an episode after that. Discovered Wicked Shipping Fleet Lockup. So this was like a semi-trailer docking area, presumably. And this should be an easy one-shot. Very nice. Military-grade duct tape. Absolutely can't have enough of that. Flip lighter. Oh, a teddy bear. That teddy bear needs a home. I'll give it to Captain Kirk. Oh, that just gave me the best idea. I'm going to start collecting all the teddy bears we find and leave them for Captain Kirk. That's just adorable. How can you not love that idea? We really don't even need to sneak here. We are so strong for enemies of these levels. I'm only at level 20. I really, really like the way this build came together. Only at level 20, and it is so strong. I don't think there's too much loot here, so we're gonna just pick up everything, even the extinguishers. Which typically are an item you want to avoid because they're quite heavy for how little resources you actually gain from them. This doesn't look right. Let's just circle back around. Nothing out here. Definitely more in that big building here. Hello. No, can't do that. Probably should have known that already, but what can you do? What can you do? So we went in that one there. Is this something? Iguana on a stick. Ooh, a safe. Oh, beautiful.
Nice.
I love it when things work out. Excuse me, Captain Kirk. Is that going to open on its own? Excellent. How about this one? All right. Oh, technical documents. I think those are going to be what we're collecting for the, I can't recall his name. The guy in the Brotherhood of Steel who we talked to at the start of the episode. The sort of a scientist-y one. The nerdy one, for lack of a better term. Oh, so we've got a trailer key, so we know we're going to get something good with this. And a comic book. Another Grognak the Barbarian. Critical hits with unarmed and melee attacks permanently do 5% damage. That is exactly what we want. We are now doing permanently 5% more damage with all of our melee attacks. You can't find much better than that with this build. But yes, that the scientist, sort of a nerdy chap that we met on the blimp, he'll be wanting those technical documents, and I believe we can sell them to him. I understand what he was asking of us. And it's worth mentioning, I did mention it in the episodes that were lost, but I haven't actually done the Brotherhood of Steel. The one time I played through this game, I went with the Institute. So, that just makes me so frustrated that I lost Brotherhood of Steel episodes, but nothing to be done about it now. Sadly, should be an easy one shot. Bonk, right on the head. Lots of adhesive here. I'm not sure if those are randomized drops or if it's always good to come here at the start to get some initial adhesive going on. That might be worth learning, if I can remember to Google it after the episode. Seems like we're wrapping this up, so we can go upstairs, or, indeed, bobby pin, chem station, yo, you're such a good boy, you figured that out all on your own. Is that a ghoul up there? I wonder. Oh, we can get on top of these. Is just a whole nother dimension of loot. Perhaps just the one thing. Still though. Some oil, some more cleaner. And we need to find where to use that key that we found. And that definitely seems to be something on the other side over there. How to get there, though, is the question. This seems to be a path. And it is. Excellent. All right. Getting good at this game, chaps. We're getting good. Oh, that looks vaguely suicide-y. But with the gun right there and the... Yeah. Quite a bleak game at times. Quite bleak. I guess there really wasn't much up here. So where is this, spot we have to find with the key? It said like storage locker or something like that. So it should be something fairly noticeable with a noticeable locked door. Should stand out, is what I'm trying to say. I do not know, off the top of my head, what we're looking for. It's not in here, I don't think. Oh, oh, almost. Almost made that jump. Let's head out the front door. Maybe it's on the left over here? No, we've been in there. Alright, chaps, I'm just going to run around for a moment, see if I can't find what to use this key on, and if I find it, you will know. Well, chaps, I could not find that little storage locker that we got the key for, but maybe we'll just happen across it in the future. Who knows? Let's take out these blood flies real quick, because they got mad at Captain Kirk, and we can't have that. Where's that one? Get back here. Little filth monster. Ooh. Idiot Savant getting work done. Getting work done. Oh. Where'd my blowflies go? Oh, oh, that's a lot of rats. Not a big issue, though. We have tons of rat away. Oops. Let's just get away from that. Stay away from there, Captain Kirk. It's not safe. There's one of the blowflies. Might as well grab that since we're going to have to rat away anyways. So let's do that. I definitely see something up ahead. Oh, we also have a little shack here to the right. This can't take too long to explore. We've got some cram, Nuka-Cola. Those are just bottles. Don't need empty bottles. Might as well take a nap while we're here. Thank you, stranger. The lights are on, yet nobody's home. That's suspicious. Bottle of whiskey. We're going to be heading right back to Sanctuary very soon, so there's no reason really not to pick all this stuff up. If anything, it's faster that way. All right. That didn't seem to be anything too essential. Little nut fruit. And lastly, I think we're just going to unlock this farming area that we can unlock for the Minutemen. And we don't need to speak to these guys yet. We'll wait until we get the quest. But now we have the fast travel location. So let's take a quick look at our work today. We've zoned out pretty much everything around Sanctuary. At some point we're going to clear this area. I would like to find all the locations in the game before the end. And in the next episode we're going to be heading back to the Pridewin for No Mercy, starting by meeting with Elder Maxon, who, sadly, you missed his introduction. It was quite stirring. He seems like quite the badass. Ooh. Ooh. Oh. Bloatfly OP. Bloatfly OP. Confirmed. Just the two of you? Darn it, those things are so hard to loot. I can never find their bodies. Oh, that red rocket station looks really cool at night. You know what? I think that is a lovely backdrop to end the episode on. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed today's episode, hit that like button for me. If you just want to help the channel grow, leave a comment. And if you'd like to subscribe for more of my content, that would be absolutely fantastic. I'd really appreciate it. And it looks like Captain Kirk found something over there, but we'll have to wait until next episode to find out what it was. Thanks, guys. I'll see you next time.